VIP pre-registration at RGPs just got even better. We here at Channel Fireball and Cascade Games are proud to offer a different exclusive, limited edition pin to our VIPs at each of the 5 Grand Prix we are hosting this year. That's Sacramento, Phoenix, Salt Lake City, Portland, and Los Angeles. If you collect all 5, you can receive the limited edition Planeswalker VIP pin. Don't stress about your GP experience this year with us. Pre-register as a VIP, sleep in, and collect pins.
Hello and welcome, my name is Caleb Durward, recording here at channelfireball.com. This is a blue-white Ephara deck. It's pretty aggressive. Your strategy against the creature decks is to curve out, play a Spear of Heliod, hope your creatures are better than theirs, maybe Detention Sphere some things, and if your creatures aren't better than theirs, you have Supreme Verdicts and Elspeths as backup to like kind of clear the way and overpower them once you get to the late game, which we can afford because we're running 26 lands, 4 of which are Mutavaults, so that kind of mitigates flooding there. Oh, we got a match coming up here. That's fine. There's not too much to discuss here anyway. The deck plays out pretty straightforward. Plays dudes until it starts playing Planeswalkers. The sideboard is also very self-explanatory. The Claustrophobias are kind of weird, but they're there to hit Blood Baron and Stormbreath Dragon out of green-red. Yeah, alright. Would you like to play first? Certainly. I think this hand's fine. Like, the temple's probably going to find us a third land. And then we'll either naturally draw a threat in the interim, or we'll hit Jace on time, and then the Jace will hit us Elspeth on time. So it's a little slow. It's a little, like, actually way slower than the deck usually has. However, there's a lot of juice here if we hit our land drops. Try it out. I'd probably send it back if the temple was like a normal plains or something. Just because the curve's so high. But if we don't have any filtering, it's a little too risky. Yeah, like we don't have an early game threat and we just had to bottom up Remaz because we need to hit land drops. I've considered upping the land count to 27. Experiment 1, go. We draw another 5 draw. This hand's looking more and more like a mulligan all the time. Whoa, he's got mid-combat stuff. Is he just gonna like rampage me? He is. Alright, I have been successfully rampaged. I hope we get our fourth land on time, because just Jace Uptick is pretty good against this board. Then next turn, it can draw us into enough lands to hit Archangel. And then hopefully that just wins. that's my big hope. Hopefully I play this stupid card and it just wins the game for me. Alright. So now that our opponent has spent the first turn playing an Experiment 1, his second turn hitting me for 4 damage, and his third turn doing nothing. Things are looking pretty good. I had all the faith in this world, in the world in this hand. I knew it would pan out. Shame on you guys for doubting me. Oh, is this a Boon Seder? I might be dead. Oh no. I guess I could have predicted that when he had nothing to do on turn 3 with his incredibly aggressive green deck. But unless he evolves the Experiment 1, he's not able to kill the Jace here. I don't know if he even wants to kill the Jace, like I'm at 14. I like that neither of these creatures have Trample. So I should get a Lavinia Fog in there somewhere. And then Elspeth. It's all a matter of like, do I live to cast these cards? Does he just have like a Mizzium Mortars for my Archangel? If I could have played the Spear on time, it would have had protection from Mizzium Mortars because it would have had a 5 toughness. That didn't happen. Yeah, I think he was deciding what he wants to do about this Jace, if anything. I'm kind of fine with him killing the Jace because, I mean, that protects my life total. And then it's like, I just get a free roll towards drawing the fifth land naturally. But yeah, it's coming at me. Makes sense. More stuff. Another Boon Seder, maybe? To evolve the experiment one? No. What the deuce? I think I remember someone saying this was, like, real close to playable. I mean, he just vibed me with it, so... Remaz, King of the Not Good Enough. Alright, let's draw some cards. Yeah. I think I'm going to get... Oh, no. Yeah. He didn't want to give me the Tension Sphere plus land. I think we're taking the land here. I think we're not too keen on it. I think we just need to slam the Archangel and pass the turn. The other option is to Lavinia here. I don't know how good that is. Although if I play Archangel and he just attacks with the Boon Seder, I almost just have to trade it off. I think I'm actually just going to play the Lavinia. Gives me a body, makes it so his guys can't attack, and then I'll get to untap with Jace and get a... basically get to free roll my Jace activation. So you can see how Archangel is probably a generally better card against more decks. But Lavinia does some things that Archangel can't, and in this case, I drew both. And Lavinia was a better play. So it's something to think about. Oh no. What's happening? Okay, he's playing Azurtas Swine. I actually don't care about that very much. Kind of want to go Archangel, land drop, tick up Jace. That, again, loses to Mizzium Mortars, though, so I'm kind of in the same place as I was the other turn. The other option is to down tick Jace and hope to hit Supreme Verdict. And he regenerates Experiment 1, and I lose to, like, another Zurta Swine or whatever. So, I can't play around everything here. Kind of unfortunate. I guess if Jace found me and come into play untapped land, I could go Elspeth, make 3/1s. It's probably better. Than this. It's kind of close. The scary part is I haven't given him a Mizzium Mortars target yet this game. And I think he's playing the card. But who knows, like, he's also playing Zurta Swine, so... maybe it's in there, maybe it's not. If he doesn't kill me this turn, I think we win, but... there's a pretty high likelihood of killing me this turn. He's just lightning striking me. Well, that's scary. Sorcery speed, lightning bolt you. Alright. I guess I'm dead to that. So, obviously he drew one of those burn spells, or he would have just killed me last turn instead of playing the Zurta Swine. There's no card that Jace could have found me that would have gained me life instantly. Maybe I needed to play Archangel a turn sooner, and that was how I won the game. But the thing is, if I play it sooner, and like he still has the Zurta Swine, so he sends in both of his guys, and I have to block something, and then I end up losing the Angel anyway. So I don't even know if that line can win either. So Boros Reckoner, pretty good in these matchups. Claustrophobia seems okay. I don't really like Fiend Slayer. I do like Archangel. What do I not like? I don't like Judge's Familiar. Really like Supreme Verdict. Lavinia looked good there. He's got red dudes, so. I think I'm gonna shave a Jace. Jace is so good, though. I'll do Spear. We'll rock this.